An eSIM is an excellent way to save money on data abroad, yet sadly, learning how to set up eSIM often isn't as simple as getting an app. So today I'm going to walk you through the eSIM tutorial steps for both iPhone and Android and show you my top eSIM picks. First, make sure your phone supports an eSIM. Most eSIM providers have a list of supported devices on their website, or you can just Google your phone model plus eSIM. Once you have that confirmation, simply pick the plan that you need, either on your eSIM app or the website, and purchase it. I'll talk a little bit about my favorite eSIMs a bit later, but if anything, links in the description will lead you to the plans of my two favorite providers. Now, upon purchase, most providers send you an email with instructions so you can look at them for reference. I'm gonna use Aralo for today's tutorial, but the setup is really similar no matter what provider you choose. The main differences actually span from what device you're trying to use an eSIM on, iPhone or Android. With Aralo SIMs though, before doing anything, I recommend checking your eSIM's additional information to see if it activates upon installation or only when you arrive at your destination. If it's the former, do the installation right before your trip. If it's the latter, you can do it days in advance. If you bought, say, the eSIM or Nomad, for example, you can do the installation in advance with peace of mind. With that out of the way, let's get started with how to set up eSIM on iPhone. First up, ensure you have a good connection. Doesn't matter if it's Wi-Fi or mobile data. Then open your eSIM app and choose the plan that you want to install. In the Aralo app, it's gonna be under My eSIMs. Tap Details, then click View Instructions. Up top, you should see three installation methods: Direct, QR code, and manual. The direct one is the easiest, so let's go with that. Now click Install eSIM and tap away through the guide. Then click Continue, wait a bit, and do not close the app under any circumstances. Let it do its thing and then click Done. Sadly, we're not done though, not just yet. You should see a prompt to add a cellular or mobile plan label. If not, all good. It will pop up later when activating the eSIM. In this screen though, tap Secondary, and then you can name it. This can be anything you want, like Aralo or eSIM USA, or I don't know, Shrek SIM. The point is, give it a name that sets it apart from your primary SIM. Then click Done. Yet again, we're not done. Tap Continue, then select your primary line for calls and text messages, which should be your main SIM. Unless you bought an Aralo plan with calls and texts, then choose the eSIM label. Then click Continue again, and now select the primary line for iMessage and FaceTime. Finally, you need to select the eSIM for cellular mobile data, and make sure that you disable the switch that allows cellular data switching, otherwise you could be hit with a data roaming charge. Tap Continue once more, and finally, we're actually done with the installation. Once you arrive at your destination, to activate your eSIM, you'll need to go into Settings, click Cellular, select your eSIM line, and then simply toggle it on. Next up, here's how to set up eSIM on Android. Just open your eSIM app, click on your plan, tap Details, and click View Instructions. Choose the direct installation, as that's the fastest one, and tap the Install eSIM option. Click Allow, wait for a few minutes without closing the app, and guess what? You're done. It's insane how different it is from eSIM iPhone shenanigans. Once you arrive at your destination, if the eSIM connection doesn't kick in automatically, you can go to Network and Internet Settings. If you're using a different provider like Saley, activation with it is clicking a button in the app. But with Saley specifically, you have to have an internet connection. A bit annoying, but you can do this right before your trip. And if you haven't yet chosen an eSIM provider, I have a list of things you should look into when searching for one. You can pause to read it. Anyway, having these requirements in mind, Aralo and Saley are my top picks, and while both will provide a solid connection, they're also very different. So far, Aralo wins in country coverage, offering over 190 countries. They also allow you to choose not just one country, but regional and global plans as well. Plus, there are plans that include calls and text messages, but they're pretty expensive. Meanwhile, Saley covers around 150 countries, with individual plans for each. The app's very easy to use, yet it's one of the cheapest providers. As I said before, you can check and compare the prices of both eSIMs through the links in the descriptions. So I recommend choosing based on your needs. If you're visiting a few countries in the same region, try Aralo plans. If you want to spend the least amount that you can, yet still get a reliable connection, choose Saley. Or choose me. I may not be an eSIM, but I upload pretty cool videos every week, so consider subscribing, and I'll see you around.